Hi, I'm Dr. Kulreet Chaudhary, neurologist and Ayurvedic practitioner. Today, I'd like to share a little bit about my story. My relationship with Ayurveda actually began in my family's home growing up, although I wouldn't have called it medicine at the time because it really had more to do with just the way we ate, meditating every day, and doing yoga. And if we did happen to get those occasional childhood illnesses, we turned to our kitchen first as a pharmacy, using things like honey and turmeric instead of going to the doctor and asking for antibiotics. It wasn't until I started my medical training, though, that I really began to appreciate the impact and the power of this knowledge. And the way that I came to appreciate it was actually by being disconnected from it. When I entered into medical school, my routine became so busy and I got really excited about this brave new world of medicine that I was learning. Ayurveda started to look kind of outdated and unnecessary. Well, fast forward to me graduating from my neurology residency, and I really paid the price of that period of disconnection. I wasn't myself anymore. I was having headaches, my digestion was off, my energy was off, and I just didn't have that same spark I did when I first entered medical school. The migraine headaches were by far the most debilitating, and as a neurologist, I felt really confident that I could take care of them. After all, I just learned all of these wonderful new medications that are used to treat migraine headaches. So one by one, I went through the prescription medications. Honestly, I don't know what was worse, some of the side effects from the medications or the headaches themselves. Frustrated after a year of experimentation, I finally decided maybe it's time that I give Ayurveda another try. After all, I never had these kinds of problems growing up, and everything that I had learned from my own neurology training had essentially failed me once I became the patient. When I went in to see the Ayurvedic physician, I was a bit suspicious about his diagnosis because he didn't tell me I had a neurological condition. He told me I had a gut problem. He gave me a program essentially for restoring gut health. I left not feeling that confident, but honestly, I didn't have any other choices. So I decided to implement all of his recommendations in terms of diet and all the herbs he gave, still questioning how could fixing my gut improve my headaches. 3 months later, I was completely headache-free. And those 10 pounds that seemed to have come on from nowhere just melted off. My energy was higher, and probably most importantly, my creativity and that spark was back. I couldn't believe it. A gut program actually helped with my migraine headaches and helped within months. I couldn't go back to my patients with the same old answers, knowing that there was a better path forward. So I decided to get my training as an Ayurvedic practitioner. And wow, was I shocked at how important the relationship was between the gut and the brain. I wouldn't even call that a relationship because what I found was they were really one functional unit. And to address any issues in the brain or the gut, you always had to address both of these areas simultaneously. This was revolutionary to me as a neurologist because I never even heard that there was a connection between the gut and the brain during my training in medical school and as a neurology resident. I began to implement these changes to my patients. And instead of just prescribing medications, I started to look at what they were eating, what the health of their gut was, and what their overall stress level was. The results were amazing. People started using fewer medications and their neurological symptoms started to improve. But one of the most important aspects of Ayurveda is that food is medicine. So your diet is critical to your overall health. And the area that patients struggled the most was in changing their diet. Now, this surprised me because my patients were extremely motivated. They were successful in many other areas of their life, and yet changing their foods was so difficult. I knew this was not a willpower issue, so I decided to study the problem. As I started to look at why my bright, motivated patients had difficulty changing the foods they ate, what I came across was quite startling. There are actually biochemical obstacles to changing the foods that you eat. Now, one of those obstacles is this connection between the gut and the brain and the impact that our modern foods have on actually creating food addictions, which completely derails the natural balance between these two systems. But also the accumulation of toxins in our bodies played a huge role in how we made healthy choices, especially when it came to our foods. As I started to understand that the underlying problem was actually biochemistry, I came up with solutions that were also biochemistry. Why not fight biochemistry with biochemistry? That's how I came up with my program, which was later outlined in my first book, The Prime. It's a program to overcome biochemical obstacles that prevent us from being able to change. As I implemented this program with my patients, not only did we see further results with their neurological conditions, but they started to experience spontaneous weight loss. I've got to tell you, I think most of my patients were more excited about the spontaneous weight loss than even the regression of some of their neurological symptoms. And what I realized from the experience was that weight loss should be spontaneous when you're re-establishing the connection between the gut and the brain, and you are removing the toxic overload that is present in most of us. When we take these steps, health is not only spontaneous, but weight loss is spontaneous because it's essentially a reflection of our overall inflammatory state and the connection between our mind and our gut. This has been an amazing journey into this relationship, and there have been so many insights that I have gained through the entire process. And I look forward to sharing those insights with you as we venture on this journey even deeper. It's exciting when you start to understand why you're not able to make certain changes. And for me, it's extremely empowering as a physician and as a teacher and as a person who went through this process myself to be able to share these simple steps with you. I'm Dr. Kulreet Chaudhary, and I hope you enjoyed learning a little bit more about me and my journey. And I wish you health and happiness in every stage of your life.